it's Gwen. Welcome back to my channel. Isn't this lighting just beautiful? We're living today. It's actually a sunny day. Today I'm bringing you all another concert vlog. I'm going to see Real Friends and Newfound Glory tonight in Boston at the House of Blues. And yeah, like I said, look at the sunshine, guys. It's actually a nice road trip day. I literally did not think this would ever happen. I'm so happy. As you guys know, if you guys have been following my last few concert vlogs, literally every single day it's been raining. I've had to drive in the rain so much recently. We have not had a good like road trip day. It's so nice out today. I think the high is like 84 85. It's really really nice. It's sunny, it's bright, it's honestly beautiful. So I'm really excited. I do want to say though, I'm really tired. I had like a girls night last night with my friends and I tried to get a lot of sleep. I didn't really sleep very well, and so I'm really tired, and like my stomach has just been like doing, I don't know, my stomach's kind of been acting up like yesterday and like this morning. I don't know, it's just doing some flips. So I'm tired too. The show doesn't start till 7, which is kind of annoying. So I don't know, I told Alex, I was like, you might have to do some of the driving later because he is the person I'm going with. Just me and him. Vama is not coming with us. She's not a huge Real Friends fan, but he's honestly the one that got me into Real Friends, so I'm super excited. Also, someone is mowing their lawn. I'm sorry if you can hear that. This is really not the time for this to be happening. He's just doing laps. All right, sorry about the background noise. But yeah, I'm super excited. It's at the House of Blues, like I said, and I've actually been to the House of Blues in Chicago, as you guys know, a few times. And this is my first time going to like a chain venue, so I'm really excited to see what it's like. Like, I don't know, I'm gonna be like looking around for obviously similarities, but also just differences between the Boston one and the Chicago one. I don't know, the concept of chain venues is really cool to me, so I'm really excited. I haven't seen Real Friends since November, and Alex hasn't seen them since last summer, so it's really really fun. It's my last time driving really really far for a while. Not like, actually not really that while, like I don't know, 3 weeks. My next time driving will be to Warped Tour, but I am going to 2 more shows before then, and Vama is driving, like my friends are driving. I don't have to drive. This is like the last show where I'm doing the actual driving in my car before Warped Tour, and I'm really happy, excited to get a break. But yeah, so at least it's a nice road trip day. It shouldn't be too bad. Hopefully I survive the day, guys. I'm really tired. I'm just trying to make it through. We might leave a little early, honestly, like during Newfound Glory, just cause like it's a late show, it doesn't start till 7, and we're only going for Real Friends. We're really not a huge Newfound Glory fan, so we'll play it by ear and see how we feel. It's like 1:30-ish right now. I'm about to leave in like a few minutes, get gas, pick up Alex, and we will be off. Yes, King. Woo!
What a day.
The realest of the Real Friends. What a great day it's gonna be. It looks like a great day. It's a sunny day.
What a great day. You are dying.
Stop numero uno. We're not thriving. We're surviving. That's my motto of the day. Survive, not thrive.
Low energy today.
Real low energy, okay. Be a miracle if I don't pass out later. We love.
Agree.
But it's such a nice day out, so it's okay. I'm getting my vitamin D. That's all that matters. Can't wait to get back on the road again. That's what I used to sing all the time when my mom and I were going to college, and she hated me for it. Just can't wait to get back on the road again. I don't even know
Willie
what it is.
Nelson.
Probably. It's some old song,
on
yeah.
On the road again.
On the road again, road again.
Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Road again. It's pretty great. I'm sweating a little bit, it's fine. Also, same rest area. I don't know how this keeps happening.
Ooh.
It's like my bladder knows. Snazzy. We made it.
Hello.
We made it. I'm so happy we're here. Ready to live life downtown. Woot woot. There was a Red Sox game and they definitely lost because people are upset. But it's fine because I don't even like Boston that much. LOL.
Yeah, fuck Boston.
Honestly. Only reason I'm rooting for the Bruins is because they're going against St. Louis and I hate the Blues with all of my burning passion. So. It's so cute over here. Wow. There she is. The Blue Blues. Ooh. Ooh. Amazing. Look at those pastel pink bands with no socks, apparently.
I was going to say something super edgy.
You should have said it. I'm just rocking these bad boys because, you know, that's what we do. We're heading to the car to drop shiz off, and then it's showtime. Very high. Oh, now it's nice. Now the breeze is good. It's not as hot as it was before.
I want to hear you!
It turns out we're broken.
was looking down and down with a finger in her thumb and the shape of an L on her forehead.
Hello, folks. So it's a few days later, and I'm just here to do a little recap on the show. Sorry, it kind of ended abruptly. I didn't film anything after we left the show. We did leave a little early. We left after, well, like half into New Found Glory's set. We wanted to hear Let It Go, Frozen, and then we left. So we left a little early. But guys, a lot of stuff happened. Overall, it was like an interesting show, to be honest, for many reasons. So I'm just gonna kind of do like a quick recap of the night. I'm really happy it ended up being a nice day out. Do have to say that. It was a really easy drive, which was very fun. We went to this cute little pub, like right by the venue before, which was really nice. And as some of you guys might know, like I said, I was a little nervous to go to the House of Blues, see what it was like, since I do not like the one in Chicago very much. But may I just say, the Boston House of Blues is like 10 times better than the one in Chicago. It was so big and open. You were not gonna like get caught outside of the pit, you know what I mean? Like, that was not gonna happen. The pit was huge, like the big space was big, and there were a lot of places on the side to go in and out, so you didn't feel trapped, which I really liked. The merch was like on the, you know, outside of everything, which was really cool. You know, inside the place, I was outside of the pit, which was really nice. Anybody could go up to the two balconies, which I really like, and the one in Chicago, they're like reserved, but anybody can go up. We were actually able to go up there for New Found Glory. Like you guys saw, we got some cool balcony shots. And then there was also like a third balcony area that was like a theater that was super high up, where there were just like seats that anyone can sit in. So I really like the space and just the openness of everything. The fact that you could go pretty much anywhere, as long as obviously you had a ticket. It didn't have to be like a special ticket, which is what I really liked. So we got there, we got to see all the bands, obviously. Before any of the bands went on, we went over and checked out Real Friends merch. Kind of checked out all the merch, but we saw Kyle from Real Friends and got to say hi to him. I got to meet him. I'll insert the photo right here. He was super, super sweet. It was really cool to meet him. I hadn't met anybody from Real Friends before, so it was super fun to be able to meet him. And we got to, you know, just talk to him a little bit. I told him how I went and saw them back in Chicago in November at House of Blues, and he was like, oh, really cool. So I was like, glad to see you guys again. And then I don't know if you guys have been aware, because I haven't really like officially announced that it's begun. I've only like teased it a little bit on this channel. But Alex and I have a podcast. If you didn't know, it's called Warped Cast. You can listen to it on Anchor, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and a bunch of other places. I have linked below both the Anchor link and the Spotify link, so you guys should definitely check it out. It's all about music. It's not specifically about Warped Tour, even though it's called Warped Cast. We just thought that name would be fun. It's really just about music. If you guys want to hear us talk more in depth about our favorite tunes, fun concert memories, all that, I encourage you guys to please check it out, give it a listen, support it. Literally, this podcast has been in the works since November 2018. Like, we've been working on this for a while, and we're really excited that, you know, the episodes have been able to come out for you guys. We already have two full episodes and a trailer up, and episodes go up basically weekly, so I really encourage you guys to go and check it out. But basically, we told Kyle about it and how our last episode was all about Real Friends, and we asked if he would be able to record a little intermission thing for us, where he would say, hi, I'm Kyle from Real Friends and you're listening to Warped Cast. And he was like, yeah, I'll totally do that. So he did it for us, which was so cool. And then he asked, you know, where can I listen to it? And I was like, oh, you can totally listen to it on Spotify. And he seemed really genuinely interested. He was like, oh yeah, I'll totally give it a listen. So he was super sweet. That was really cool. And then we, you know, found a spot in the crowd. We were pretty close. We got to see Dollskin, which were super good. They had so much energy. It was great to see them. And then we saw the early November, which it was just, I don't know, I know some of their songs. The crowd was kind of meh for them, and they were okay, you know, not as great as I was expecting. I think Dollskin impressed me a bit more than they did personally, and I think that the crowd was more into Dollskin than they were into the early November. And then Real Friends was about to come on, and we were like third row, and Alex was like, do you want to open up the pit? And I was like, yes, I do, but I also want to take advantage of the fact that we're this close. And they opened with Mess, so I was like, why don't we hear like the soft beginning of Mess from this, you know, third row, cool, really close up area, and then when the, you know, chorus hits, like, I'm still a lost boy, we can go into the, open up the pit, you know? And he was like, deal, sounds good. And this is one of the bad parts about the night. So one of the really crappy parts about the show was the crowd, and it kind of ruined, I would say it ruined Real Friends for us, because Real Friends was great, but the crowd was not. Also, the security kind of sucked a little bit too, but I'll get into that. So Mess begins, they come on, Dan still has his beard, which we were both just shook about. He just, I don't know, he looks a lot older with a beard. Not hating on it, it's just like really funny. He looks like a dad. Anyways, so they come out, they start Mess, and we're jamming, and then, you know, gets to the chorus, and we open up the pit. Like anybody would do, like normally. Like, we just start pushing away, like people, not crazy, we're just like opening it up. And these three big dummies just start targeting Alex and just go after him. And one guy literally punched him in the head for no reason. And I was like, what the hell is going on? Alex is over there. He's like, what the fuck's happening? And so somebody grabs him to pull him back. Not like he was gonna fight, but I think someone thought they were gonna start a fight. And then I got in front of the two guys and I was just like, hey, like, calm down. Like, what are you doing? It was so weird. And they just got pissed at us for literally no reason. And like, I will never understand. We both of us just like do not understand why that happened. Like, I'm still so confused because I'm gonna put it this way, about 90% of the crowd was there for Newfound Glory. I get it. And they're an older band, so there was an older crowd. But these weren't even like a bunch of older guys that just like were like, ew, teenagers moshing, I don't wanna mosh, I hate Real Friends. Because then they were singing every word to Real Friends. It made no sense. So that kind of like put a damper on Alex's mood because he was pissed and in a bad mood. And then the actual pit kind of sucked. Nobody really moshed. And when they did, it was like really crappy, like moshing. It was not great pit. So I did crowd surf once, as you guys saw, and I also got a clip of Alex crowd surfing once as well. He had a fun time crowd surfing until the end of it. He got set down and got to sing into the mic because, you know, Dan was putting it down for him. And then I don't know what happened. The security guard just decided to punch him as like in the stomach or something while he was singing to the mic, because he wasn't moving, even though the mic was put down for him. Like, I don't know what it is with House of Blues security, but I'm about to file a complaint, because, like, we've both had issues now with that. So, I don't know, the set was great. Like, nothing, you know, the Real Friends didn't do anything wrong. They were super fun. The energy in there just kind of sucked for them, and the pit sucked. And that whole thing in the beginning, those two dudes, three dudes, like, it made us annoyed. So, you know, it was a good set. I'm really glad I got to see them again. They did play a lot of good songs, and I did get to mosh a little bit. I did get to crowd surf, and it was fun. And then after that, I got to actually meet a subscriber. So I got to meet up with a girl that I've been mutuals with on Twitter for a few months now. She's from Boston, so we've been trying to meet up at a Boston show, and it finally worked out. Shout out to you, Taylor, if you're watching this. It was super great to talk to you and meet you, and I hope to meet you again. But yeah, I just love meeting you guys at shows, so that was super, super fun. We did get some water, which it was free, which is great because the other House of Blues, it's not. So that was really fun. And then we decided to go up to the balcony, the second balcony, to watch Newfound Glory. We were tired and just kind of like over being down there with that crowd. I was just so done with the crowd. So we went upstairs. Alex also did get a pick from Real Friends. It says Real Friends on one side and it says Eric on the other because it's Eric's pick. He's one of the guitarists. So that was pretty cool. I tried, but I didn't get anything. And it didn't even look like they were giving out set lists at all. They had no set list on the stage, so we couldn't even get a set list. But we went upstairs, we hung out, we watched about half of Newfound Glory's set, maybe a little less than half. They opened with Eye of the Tiger, which was super fun. They played All Star before they even came on. The backdrop was really, really cool. It looked like a marquee. There was like a ticket, you know, sign, a popcorn sign, a red carpet. As you guys can see in the videos, you know, they were all dressed up. It was really, really cool. I'm glad we did get to stay for some of Newfound Glory, because even though we didn't go for them, it was just such a cool kind of theatrical vibe to everything. It was really fun to watch, and it was a cool view up there in the balcony. So we got to hear some fun songs. We wanted to stay and hear Let It Go from Frozen, which we did, and I'm very happy we did. And then we left after that. But before we left, I wanted to actually get some merch. I saw this pennant on their website, Real Friends, you know, they posted about it, and I was like, ooh, might get that to hang up in my apartment in the fall, and I did, in fact, end up getting it. It's just like a felt pennant, looks like this. I like that it's just black and white, goes with everything, and I really like that it has a rose and it says Chicago Suburbs, because I think that's gonna look really cute in my apartment in Chicago in the fall, you know. And then I also decided to get the Composure vinyl as well because it was only $20 and it was one of my favorite albums of 2018, and I just feel like I would have regretted if I didn't end up getting it because, you know, you get vinyl at shows and it's so cheap. It was also the tour exclusive, like the tour variant, so I'm glad I got it too because it's not only beautiful, but it also matches the album artwork so well. It was called Daiquiri, so this is what the vinyl looks like. There's the back. It is a gatefold with all the lyrics, which is super fun. I really just love the artwork. And then, like I said, the vinyl is Daiquiri, and it comes in this really nice sleeve, and it's kind of like a marble pink and white. And yeah, that is what it looks like. I love it so much. It is just so pretty, and I just love that it matches like the bird on here. It's a bit darker in person. It looks kind of light on camera, but it matches the bird and the leaves. And I just think that it just matches the album perfectly. And I listened to it yesterday, I spun it, and I was like, I'm so glad I picked this up because it's like, it's kind of a short album. It's only like 30 something minutes, but every single song is just great. I bopped to it. So I'm really happy I got this. Alex ended up picking up the acoustic, Even More Acoustic Songs EP on vinyl. So we both got a vinyl, and you know me, I like don't really ever get merch at shows anymore, but I was like, you know what? I'm feeling it. I love Real Friends. They were so sweet, so great. And you know, we were there to see them. And then as we were leaving the venue, this is total coincidence, and like I'm really surprised this happened. This is just luck, because obviously we're leaving the venue early, we cross the street to leave, and you know, we look both ways because we're a good pedestrian, and it was actually Alex that noticed it. Alex looked as we were crossing the street, and he sees Dan from Real Friends walking around the side of the tour bus, and he turns and goes, "Hey, Dan Lanton." It's really, really funny. And I was like, oh my God, of course he noticed that we just heard, like, called his name, and he was like, I don't even know if he waved. He might have done something like, hey. He had like a cup of tea in his hand. His throat wasn't doing well, but we wanted to ask him a question. If you guys do listen to the podcast, you'll know that we had a question that we wanted to ask him. So we see him, and I run up, and I'm like, Dan, I just have a really quick question for you, because like, I didn't want to annoy him, because obviously he's not inside, like, he, you know, is not standing by the merch table waiting to meet people. So I was like, I have a really, really quick question for you, and he was like, what's up? Yeah. And so we basically asked if he had a little feature in Evergreen by Knucklepuck at the end, if it was true, because we thought that we heard his voice, but we couldn't tell if, you know, we were just crazy or not, if it was really him. And he was like, yes, I do. And we were like, oh my God, it's been confirmed. I was so happy. So that was really fun. And then we also, you know, kind of just said hi to him. I said, you guys did fantastic. We came here for you. Told him about Chicago as well and how I've seen them before and how they're fantastic. And then we also did tell him same thing about the podcast to see if we could get him to say, hi, I'm Dan from Real Friends and you're listening to Warpcast. But his voice was so messed up. He was like, I tried, guys, but the AC fucked me up in there. He literally like could not speak. I felt so bad. So we were just like, hey, it's totally, totally fine. Hope you have a great rest of your night. It was super great to meet you. Hope to see you again soon. But that was like amazing that we got to meet Dan. It's so cool. And no, before you guys ask, I did not tell him like, hey, do you remember a girl you held the door for at Beat Kitchen in March? Because that was me. I didn't say that. I thought that'd be a little weird to say, but he did. He did do that. So it was cool to actually like formally speak to him this time, and he was very sweet. And that was all just luck that we happened to like be walking outside and like left at that time that he was, you know, walking outside too. That was total luck. So that was a really great way to end the night, get that confirmation, get to meet him. And yeah, I would say that other things like meeting the band members, getting cool merch, meeting a subscriber, that kind of thing kind of made up for the fact that the crowd sucked. Because honestly, the set wasn't great, and it, like I said, it was not the band's fault. It was just simply that the crowd sucked. You know, it started off really bad. It started off with Alex being punched in the face, which is, I don't understand to this day what happened. Like, I'll never understand, I feel like. So yeah, you know, I think we made the best of it overall. I think that, you know, we had a good time. It was really nice outside that day, so we really did make the best of it, and I'm really glad we went still, just because so many other cool things happened that I wasn't expecting to happen. So yes, I hope you guys enjoy this concert vlog. Let me know if you guys are going to any of the dates on this tour, or if you guys have gone to any of the dates. Please let me know your experience down below. I would love to hear it, or tell me your favorite Real Friends or Newfound Glory song, because I'd love to know. Give this video a big thumbs up if you guys liked it, and subscribe if you haven't already. And other than that, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!